Hello, 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 and welcome back to N Raghav TV for yet another video. This time discussing my Euro predictions. So let's get started. So before moving on to my Euros prediction, I would like to announce that we have created a Euros Fantasy League. If you don't know, let me explain it to you. This is a fantasy league where you will be given a transfer budget imaginary, and you can pick a starting 11 and compete with all others in the world. And we have created a league where you can compete with other players and top the league. So if you haven't joined the league yet, do check out the link in the description. And also, if you are using the Euros app, then there is a code given in the description through which you can join as well. So let's get started with my Euro predictions. Okay, let's get started with Group A first. Although people have been saying that Group F, which is France, Portugal, Germany and Hungary, is the group of death, Group A is an interesting one because, according to me, the two underdogs of this tournament, which is Turkey and Italy, are in this group. So let's start with the bottom team. I think Wales would finish bottom at 4th, because although they have Gareth Bale, the best player in the world, but still I don't think they don't have what it takes to finish in the top 2. Let's go on to the third position, which is not quite obvious, but I think it is expected that Switzerland will finish 3rd, because although they have certain good players, but still not strong enough to compete. Now let's talk about Turkey. Turkey is an interesting pick because before this, in the international break, they played quite a few heavyweights and they upsetted quite a few of them. They have very good players like Brian Yilmaz, who is the striker from Lille, who won the league on this season. And they have a good centre-back partnership of Demiral from Juventus. They have Soyuncu from Leicester City, who is a quality centre-back, and I feel Turkey is going to finish 2nd. And let's come to the group table toppers, Italy. Italy, an interesting fact is that Italy are unbeaten since 2018. Let it sink in. Italy are unbeaten since 2018, and they haven't conceded a goal in their last 8 games. So I think Italy are quite an underrated team in the tournament, because if you see, people who are picking their favorites are mostly England. It's either Belgium, England, or it's France. I feel Italy are going to be a big surprise and dark horse of the tournament, and no disrespect to Turkey as well. I think these both teams are going to be the underdogs of this tournament. Now let's move on to Group B, which is not a big surprise. Let's finish off with the table toppers. I think it's going to be Belgium, no doubt. And I feel Denmark are going to finish 2nd. This is because of the man, the myth, the legend, Martin Braithwaite. I think he's going to take them to 2nd. Just kidding. But I think Denmark do have a decent team. Russia to finish 3rd. Yeah, not much special about them. And even Finland to finish 4th. Let's move on to Group C. I think this is the easiest group of the tournament. I think Netherlands should easily top the group, but Frank de Boer has been quite underwhelming, and he's not convinced me that Netherlands are going to go far in the tournament, although I have put them in first in this group because I don't feel there's much competition. I think Austria will finish 2nd. They have decent players like David Alaba, they have Sabitzer, Yusuf Paulsen as well. And so, yeah, let's see. Then Ukraine to finish 3rd, Zinchenko Army, and then North Macedonia to finish 4th. Let's move on to Group D, which is England's group, which is quite interesting because if you look at the group, there is Scotland, England, Croatia and Czech Republic. If you look at in this group, Scotland is quite an underrated team again, because they have the likes of Kieran Tierney, they have Andrew Robertson, and few good players in their team. So I think, top two contenders is going to be either England or Croatia. I might disappoint a few fans here, but I am going with Croatia to finish the top. I don't trust Gareth Southgate. Because if you see, if England finish first, they'll have to face the winners of Group F, I think, which will be a big trouble. So it is a blessing in disguise, but I would say that if England finish first, it would be a carry job. But I'm not quite sure whether to still put Croatia first or not. Let me reconsider it. I think I'll go Croatia second. It's too big of a gamble to put England second. Let's go England first, Croatia second, Scotland third, and Czech Republic fourth. Yes, they have, Czech Republic also have a few decent players like Suchek and Kufal, but I don't see them finishing in the top three at least. Now let's move on to Group E, the group I am quite interested in after Group F, because I support Spain, and I'm going to go with Spain to finish first. Although Poland have Lewandowski, but I don't see them going for, you know, going top two. Let's put Poland in three. I'm going to pick, the interesting thing is between Slovakia and Sweden. I'll go Sweden second. It might be a surprise pick, but they do have a good team. Although Poland, again, I'm confused between Poland and Sweden. I'll come back to it after Group F. Slovakia to finish fourth. Let's move to Group F, the most interesting group in this tournament, because you have three, you know, although Germany, people don't consider Germany as favorites, but they are one of the huge nations, one of the giant nations in terms of footballing. So these three heavyweights will clash in Group F with alongside Hungary, who I feel bad for because I think they're going to finish fourth. Now let's move on to third position. I think everyone is going to agree with this, and Germany is going to finish third for me, because I don't, this with the squad that Portugal and France have, I don't see Germany, although even Germany have a good squad. I'm not, there's no disrespect to Germany here, but if Germany is this level, then France and Portugal are this level, if it is visible in the camera. So let's move on to the first and second. Again, controversial. France, Portugal. I'm going to go Portugal first. It seems controversial, but I'm going to go Portugal first and France second. I think somehow Portugal will pull it off and, you know, nick a 1-0 or a 2-0 wins against these big teams. So that's my group predictions. First of all, let's go through it again. Group A, Italy, Turkey, Switzerland, Wales. Group B with Belgium, Denmark, Russia and Finland. Group C with Netherlands, Austria, Ukraine, North Macedonia. Group D with England, Croatia, Scotland, Czech Republic. Group E with Spain, Sweden, Poland, Slovakia. And Group F, last but not the least, Portugal, France, Germany and Hungary. Now let's go with my four best third finished place teams. I think one of them is going to be Germany for sure. Then I'm going to go Scotland, Poland and Switzerland. These are my top, these are my, you know, four best third place teams. It's going to be Germany, Poland, Scotland and Switzerland. Now let's continue to the knockout stages. So as you can see the roadmap here, the round of 16, where according to the fixtures, if my predictions are right, these will be the fixtures for round of 16. Belgium will face Poland, Italy face Austria, my bad, Portugal face Switzerland, Croatia face Sweden, Spain face Scotland and England face France, and Netherlands play Germany, Turkey play Denmark. So let's start from top and then go to the most big games. Belgium, Poland, easy pick. I'm going Belgium to progress to the quarterfinals. As I said again, Italy are the dark horses of this tournament. I think Italy are going to go to the quarterfinals easily. Portugal, I don't see Switzerland beating Portugal as well, and same goes for Croatia. So Portugal and Croatia to the second match of the quarterfinals. Spain and Scotland, I think it's quite predictable again. Although Scotland have a decent team, but Spain will progress to the quarterfinals. England and France. This is where it gets interesting. These two matches, because England, the fans are very positive, it's going to come home this time. But again, under Gareth Southgate, I don't see it. As I said in my England video as well, I see France easily going through and beating England in the round of 16. Netherlands and Germany, this one is interesting because both teams have been quite underwhelming for me, because Netherlands under Ronald Koeman were awesome. Netherlands team under Ronald Koeman was awesome, but Frank de Boer, you know, he's quite rigid and he wants to play 5-3-2 anti-football. So I'm quite doubtful of what Netherlands can do this Euros. And also for Germany, although they have a quite awesome squad, Germany, but quite doubtful. But I'm going to pick Germany here. Although I don't think it is a surprise, but if it is a surprise, do let me know in the comments where you think I've made a mistake. And as I said again, Turkey and Denmark. Turkey are going to be quite an underdog story in this tournament. So Turkey go through. So as I have picked, let's go through my quarterfinal setup again. So it's Belgium, Italy in the first quarterfinals. Then it's Portugal, Croatia, Spain, France, Germany, Turkey. Let's start from the bottom now. Germany and Turkey. Again, as I said, Turkey an underdog story, and Germany is a safe pick, but Turkey is an underrated pick. So if I think here, I think I'm going to go Germany. Germany, I think although Turkey have a decent team, and I said they're going to be the underdogs of this tournament, but I don't see them going past Germany. Let's move on to the interesting one, which is Spain and France. Although I support Spain, and you know the quite controversial Spain squad, which Luis Enrique has picked, do check that video as well, linked in the description, and it will come on I button this side or this side. I think France are too good of a team to, you know, for Spain to beat, so I'm going to go France. Portugal, Croatia is another interesting one, because Croatia, you know, many people don't pick Croatia as favorites, because although they have a very, very good squad, they have Rakitic, they have Modric, they have Kovacic, they have Rebic, they had Mario Mandzukic, and you know, they have very good squad, but Portugal, man, I think they will go through. They will go through. They have too much quality. Again, as I said, same in the case of Germany and Turkey. I think Portugal are going to go through as my semifinals. And again, this one is going to break so many hearts. So many people think that Belgium are going to go through their their golden generation, their Euro winners, most. Team, most people are thinking, but don't underestimate Italy at all, because I haven't seen all the prediction videos. I've seen many so far. I haven't seen many people pick Italy going through so far and so deep in the tournament, but I'm going to go ahead and do it. It's going to be controversial. If you think it's controversial, again, do let me know your thoughts on this in the comments. I'm going to pick Italy over Belgium. I feel so bad doing this. You know, I like De Bruyne. I like all the Belgian players. Hazard, Thorgan Hazard, Lukaku, all those players. But I think Italy are going to go through. So let's start with the first semi-final. So the semi-final picks are Italy and Portugal and France and Germany. So I think this one is quite obvious. I don't see Germany beating France. So France is going through to the finals, and Italy, Portugal. Again, I might be so wrong, but if I get this right, you know, then Do remember, I was the first one to say that Italy are going to go to the finals. Just remember it. Bookmark, clip it, whatever you want. Just remember that I was the one who first picked Italy to go to the finals, and I am doing it. I am sorry, Ronaldo fans, Felix fans, Fernandez, United fans. I am so sorry, but I think it is Italy season. The finals again. Italy, France. Final. I think it's going to be France. I think France are going to win the Euros this time. So I think France are going to be my Euro winners for 2020. So that was my predictions for Euro 2020 or 2021, if you want to call it. I picking France to be my winner. And Italy to be the underdog story, including Turkey as well. So just remember, I called it first, Italy in the finals. And if you like the video, do like, share, and also subscribe to the channel if you like the content. Also, I've created a Discord server if you would like to have chats or give some suggestions. Do join in, and also do let me know your thoughts about my Euro predictions for this summer. Thank you for watching the video.